All right, so let's talk about Valkyrie. So Valkyrie was definitely the last song that we wrote. And as we were sort of saying before, it did kind of stretch out until pretty close to the album's production. We've got a bad habit of doing that. And I think it won't stop now. But Valkyrie was kind of a song that we wrote with full knowledge of what else we had on the record. And we knew that we had a lot of kind of, you know, pumpy, energetic kind of intensity. But I think we kind of wanted to raise it up another notch, if that's fair to say. What do you guys think? I think that was kind of my mission statement with Valkyrie anyway.
Yeah, we had to turn it up to 11. Yes. The 11 number.
I think 12 even.
It was very much like, I remember the conversation being something along the lines of like, you know, while this, the ideas of this are coming out, we're just going like, okay, this would absolutely crush live. This is going to be really exciting to play live. And that almost became like a mission statement early on of like, let's construct a song that has that energy that is purely for just like, let's go. You know what I mean? That total live vibe. And that's totally what I love about it.
Yeah, me too. I think I tortured you a little bit with the bass stuff on that, right, Dale? I remember that being a bit of a slog.
That was fun. That was a good. That was
say
good.
No more.
You can hear the bass. That was a big learning curve. That was like big step up. It's like, hey, welcome to Seahorse, play some Valkyrie.
Yeah, I mean the bridge section too. It stands out as kind of really cool, like bass. Actually, bass and drum unison. That was another thing we talked about building. And incidentally, there's kind of a similar thing in Autumn in a different setting. But I remember sort of saying, you know, we want to have one of those big, almost like counterpoint kind of sections, contrapuntal parts where we've got sort of Jim's vocals sitting on top of all of these other instruments coming in all of the gaps. It took quite a while to construct that, but I adore that section. That's probably one of my favorite sections on the album, I think.
I had such a fondness for that section because I remember we were walking through South Bank in Brisbane, and I think we were discussing whether we like bass solos or not. And we're like, I'm pretty sure we like bass solos.
And of course the answer was we do not.
and so I think that...
Context.
Yes.
That whole section was composed around the bass solo, from what I remember, right, Sam?
No, you're exactly right. So my original image was to kind of have that repetition of that introductory guitar pattern that's all kind of 16th notes, and then atop of that kind of have the drums and the bass lock in to create an interesting kind of rhythm and melody away from it. So the guitar goes from being the focal point at the start when it plays that in its first instantiation and then comes back in there as this backing part instead. I thought it was kind of fun, and the bass line becomes, you know, the point of focus, or at least it dances between being Jim as the focus and then the bass in all of the spaces. Pretty cool section. Pretty proud of that one.
In the beginning of that bridge section, I took the guitar part and put a portion of it on the hi-hat pattern. And it was really cool. That was one of the first times that it occurred to me, and it was a space to actually do that and go, hey, that's something else I can grab onto and just have that nice little, you know, nice little spice on top of the part. It was really cool, dynamically speaking.
Oh, that was so cool, because that was actually something when we were putting the demo together, I kind of had a really rudimentary version of that. It was more just like a unison between the hats and the accents and the guitar part. But when you sort of started playing it, and we had that, you know, that big rise and fall of the dynamics whenever the guitars ramp, it sort of felt like instead of being this shotgun 16th note thing, it was like this kind of ebbing, flowing, you know, breathing part. I remember sort of thinking, yeah, this is really coming together. This makes it make a lot more sense. But I'd love Jim to get an idea of those lyrics. I think it came from that. It came from a quote, if I'm not mistaken.
You tell me. I don't.
So my memory is my wife being in labor, and me being the sweaty mess on the phone to you guys, being like, man, she is a Valkyrie. It's crazy.
Yeah, I got a message from you during that, because we're checking in, obviously, and she goes like, I'm doing fine. Steph is a Valkyrie, and that was sort of like the. The end of it. And so that word was just sort of like just drilled in the back of my head, obviously. And when we were originally writing the song, I think a lot of the themes that came out in the verses, incidentally, you know, as writing them, I'm just going like, fuck, this is like it's like a letter to myself when I'm younger, just telling me to calm down. Just like, just be patient. It's fine. You know, just keep working on your stuff and just keep going. There's no need to rush. Don't get so angry all the time. And that came through into the chorus, and just basically literally saying it's all right. And I wanted to have something that, an image, there was a missing word, I remember, and I wanted to have something that was an image of something that was beautiful, that was powerful, that could be seen as fragile, that same kind of thing about the deer on the front cover. And I ended up landing on the Valkyrie, which is, you know, again, this amazingly powerful thing with these beautiful soft wings, and also representing, because they're the choosers of the slain, they show up at the end of a battle, it's like, it's just end the war, just stop. It's fine, just wait. And that was the theme. It's like me looking at myself in the past and just going, dude, please, please, man, please.
So, yeah. I am glad I don't have to meet 17-year-old me ever.
Yeah.